So the first icon I come and stand before is the icon of the Trinity. I just look at it and different things will come to my mind. For example, we see here the Father who's in resplendent clothing, the invisibility of God behind the Father, the mansion for which we have been created to be with God forever. We then see in the middle Jesus, who's gazing at love upon the Father. Behind him is the tree. We normally associate the cross with suffering, which of course it was. But here we see it as the tree of life. Jesus, we were created to be with God forever. Sin disrupted that, but Jesus has opened up for us again, eternal life. And we see here the chalice of suffering, reflecting too on the Eucharist. And we see here the Holy Spirit being symbolized, and behind the mountain, because quite often the scriptures, the mountain is a place where we experience God. Ultimately, of course, we experience God within ourselves, and we are temples of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit is also dressed in green, because the Spirit brings us life, new life with God. And finally, I love to look at how the three persons of the Trinity are in a circle symbolizing their love, and yet there's a gap in that circle, a gap because the love of God flows out towards humanity and wants to catch me up in it and to bring me back, and indeed all of us, back into the love of the Trinity. And I find that a beautiful thought at the beginning of each day, that God's love is pouring out towards me and towards all people and wanting to catch us up in that river of love and bring us together back into the Lord.